You said fuck me, and I was like, cool. Mm-hmm. So now what's the problem?
Fire in the hole!
At first I was on the scene. Niggas was petrified. Ran back to the lab and all you niggas start a homicide. My podcast style will flip the style and it will do you niggas wrong. And all you motherfuckers sleeping on us, our podcast will do you on. I don't even know what made me say that, but you niggas said fuck us, cool. Fuck you too! Fire squad! Level up! We're here, your captain, Jimmy Barr! The Admiral, G Money!
Sometimes you gotta talk to the crew.
And we got eyes low!
Just a couple questions.
Let's go!
Hey. Yo, I wanna know where crisis when I'm in a crisis and why I lean on other devices. I'm sick of living wicked one day, next minute I'm righteous. Just tell me what the meaning of life is. You made me with a purpose, why work? Can I just do that? How I take a step forward just to take two back? What's the lesson? I'm trying to learn, but I'm sick of guessing. If I'm human, why you asking for perfection? You said before the world you chose me. I don't feel so lucky. If I'm so wonderfully made, why I feel so ugly? How is sin so wicked when it feels so lovely? Guess my question is, do you still love me? How you see us in this chaos and got the power to change it and won't? I would do it if I could, but I can't because I don't. Then he told me, keep faith. The answer is hope. Keep walking. I'm enhancing your growth. You so close to beginning to know.
All right.
Wondered if that technique worked, you know, where they could be up here. No one will know. I don't know. What a way to start over the show. What up, guys? What's up, man? This is Fire in the Hole and Why, Jimmy Barr. And I'm your captain. This is G Money.
What up,
Jimmy? The Admiral. How was your fucking 4th of July, man?
It was fun, man. It was fucking.
We're not going to just let you set it up. Nah, you're not going to just pass on by this. No. Let's let the world know, G Money. A lot of y'all know G-Money White Chocolate out there, right? Y'all know that nigga White Chocolate. And that nigga like his motherfucking chocolate, deep chocolate, caramel. You know what I mean? My man is into those flavors. You know what I mean? And his Nubian queen, okay? His Nubian queen had him go to the family reunion down in South Carolina this weekend, all right? They were down there for South Carolina family reunion. Now, y'all all know about that South, okay? Y'all know about that South. And they're not too fond of that interracial, okay? That interracial. Now, I was concerned for G-Money. I was like, yo, fam, you're about to head down there, all right? And I want to let you know, those folk down there, those folk that got that authority, yeah, those guys that got that hat with the swoop, you know that swoop hat on the highway, you know that little hat, yeah, I know the hat I'm talking about, but it's not the hat that I was concerned about. It's the haircut that's under that hat. If you ever get pulled over by this haircut guy, where the haircut starts right here, it's a shag of hair that comes, not the shag going backwards, not like Kanye West had it knock you out with Kerry Hilson video. It's the reverse way, where it's this, it starts right here, and then it goes up. And it's just real, it's a layer of a real perfectly cut, shagged, pointy hair, you know what I mean? And those guys, they don't play. They don't play, man. G-Money was down there. He was down there, and he was down there with the folk, with the people. With the people.
Yes, I was.
Living the Dr. King dream. Okay? My man was down there. We shall overcome. Yeah, my man was, we shall overcome. I don't know what kind of come you. I'm not talking about C-O-M-E, niggas. I'm chill, Mo. Don't beat me up. You know, I'm on play. Listen to me. My man, what was it like? Talk to us. You was down there, baby. Did you bring the videos, the camera and stuff? Did you?
I did it. We took some pictures at like when we took walks around the parks and stuff like that.
At the actual reunion.
Yeah, they had cameras and stuff like that. But
so you didn't want to let them know, hey, this is what I did too. You know? Hey, I could get involved. They didn't want you with that footage. They didn't trust you. They didn't trust an outsider of the culture with that footage. Yeah, you're in, but not all the way in. You're going to have to go a couple more reunions before you're allowed to actually film, you know, the family partakes.
Yeah, if I show up the first time with the camera, they'll think I'm a spy or something.
Alphabet boy.
Yeah.
They're going to be looking at Mo like, what's going on here, girl? What'd you bring down here? What's
my camera and a windbreaker. Yeah. Hey, family.
Hey, yo, you know what? I need me an FBI windbreaker check.
Yeah, you do.
You know, yes, No, I don't. No, I just realized I don't. Let me help myself.
I know. I should be help saying myself. No, I don't. You're absolutely
because,
right.
Because, bro, don't give me an FBI fleece jacket, nigga. Are you crazy? I will be a FBI citizen agent. Making citizen seizures and stops. Yeah. I'll be an honorary citizen agent for the FBI. Don't give me that fleece, man. Don't worry about giving me a badge and none of that stuff. I have a wallet. I have an ID. You know what I mean? Because let me tell you something. That badge don't mean nothing. All you need is a wallet, and you got to just know how to flash it, bro. You got to hit those niggas real fast. Excuse me. Come here. Hey, bro. Listen, look. This is it, dog. It's FBI flash. Listen. I'm a citizen agent. Martinez. This fleece jacket should let you guys know if I'm over here, you're doing something wrong. That's what the fleece jacket says. I don't know, but listen to me. Yeah, you're right. You would have been an FBI or something. You would have been something down there, man. Yeah. You don't want to give me those tools. You don't want to give me I don't need a gun. Nah, man. I'm an FBI agent, honorary citizen agent that uses energy to take down criminals. I'm an energy doer.
What about the hat? They gave you just the hat, FBI hat with the suit or something. Just walk.
I mean,
walking the beat.
Yo, bro, don't do that. Not with that FBI, because I would duck it all the way out. You know how the white boys get that duck for the motherfucking spring break? You know that duck? Yeah, look at yours. Yours is a baby duck. You got a Daffy duck. You know. You got a red Daffy duck hat. But nah, I'll duck mines all the way out. And the more it's ducked, the more authority you feel you have, bro. It's the ducker, the hat, the more authority you look at the experience of whenever hats have been involved with authority figures, how aggressive they are by the brim. Look at the brim aggression. Look at the history of the brim aggression. Yeah, is it just me that can we kind of weigh in on this? It's like the more ducked the hat is, the more ducked out. Yeah. The more ducked out, the more aggressive you're gonna be. you don't even have to fully see crime going on. You'll just be yelling in an authoritative voice. Hey! Anyone that's out there during crime will be like, whoa, what's going on? Yo, chill, yo, it's FBI authority, honorary citizen agent. Yeah, you just don't want to duck it out too much, man. I don't know, man. I'm sorry I hijacked your experience down in South Carolina. Can you please tell us what was South Carolina like with you and Mo, man?
It was cool, man. Just vacations, more so meeting my girlfriend's family than, you know, anything else being different. But that was cool. Everyone was very nice.
You can tell when a nigga, the pussy's regular now. You can tell when the pussy is regular, dog. If this was brand new, that nigga, well, you know, I got to meet Uncle Kenneth. he's a mechanic down there. You know, this nigga right here, everything's regular. You know who you are? You are Dirt Diggler after the second round of awards, where he's just, yeah, I'm here, guys. You know? You're not the Dirk Diggler on the first round of the war. Hey, man, if you guys keep making great movies, I'm going to keep on out here keeping it on. That's what we're going to do. Let's do it.
I think I'm still getting my energy back from being.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I was from being, oh, how are you? How you doing? I was doing that all. Oh. That was my weekend. So now I'm just like, yeah, it's cool, man. You know,
he was playing the white boy role.
Not even that.
This nigga went white boy on them down there. He's like, there's no need for me to hood out. Yeah, I know I got the chocolate in me, but I think I'm going to go Caucasian on this trip. That Caucasian gives me some sort of a pass, you know. Niggas is talking about Mo. Her family is like, hey, did y'all see Monique and her boyfriend? Did y'all see him? Yeah, I was hanging out with him. I was watching them take pictures around the park. Hey, he all right. He got a good eye for pictures. Maybe after a couple of more reunions, he could take some family photos of us doing what we do, like making hamburgers. My man, you survived.
I did. I survived. And then I came back before 4th of July, and I spent 4th of July in probably the most American way, trying to play baseball in the morning without stretching.
The American way.
And then pulling my hamstring, and then drinking all day, and then not resting my hamstring, and now
whoa. So you didn't even know your hamstring was.
Oh, I knew, but I was just like,
you were drunk.
I thought the pool and alcohol was
going to remedy
therapy.
It.
Yeah,
I love white people. Their methods are so crazy. It's
like I'm soaking it. You know, I'm fucking relaxing.
You know,
yeah.
I want to talk. So what did you do that? Besides American baseball. What else did you do that was American? That was down at the shore?
Yeah, down at the shore, yeah. Mm. I had burgers and hot dogs. Mm. You know.
Ballparks or Nathan's?
I think they were ballparks.
Mm.
Yeah.
You love a ballpark. Huh? Love a ballpark. You want to be an umpire.
I tried to be an umpire.
For a little league or some shit.
Yeah,
like.
Me and Cadet Joe tried.
Ah, they ain't trusting y'all niggas,
man. No, they did it. We fucking, they did it. They called us once. We went. I bought the shirt and everything. They fucking called me one time as a formality and then never fucking called me again. I got paid $15 for being a base umpire.
Oh, my God.
And the shirt
cost
$28.
That's hilarious. So the Little League owes you fucking money.
Yeah, they do, those motherfuckers.
Oh, my God, man. That's American. Who made the potato salad?
Who made the potato salad? I don't think we have potato salad.
I don't think
we have macaroni
people normally
salad.
Because y'all do weird shit to the potato salad. White people, why do you add raisins and granola to the potato salad? What the fuck are y'all doing,
I've
man?
I've never had raisins in that.
Yeah, food. Yeah. I'm proud of you.
We're Italian, so we're like
sub-white. Y'all different. That Italian, you know, y'all niggas need a strong 79 hours to prepare a Sunday dinner, you know? Yeah, that's 79 hours. 79. The preparation for that sauce. I don't even call it pasta.
No, it's gravy.
It's gravy, yeah, the gravy. Let me tell you something about gravy, nigga. I had an Uncle Donald that used to drink thick gravy. Nigga, just regular thick gravy. Nigga, just put that shit on the motherfucking stove inside of a jar. And water, and let that shit warm up the gravy where it's textured, and just so he can, yeah, Uncle Donnie used to drink thick gravy, turkey gravy, meatloaf gravy, but his favorite was chicken gravy, man. I don't know what was up with Uncle Donald, dog. That's a wild shit. Just, go get me one of those can of, there's a jar. It's a fucking jar.
A jar.
Don't give me a jar of that chicken gravy in there. Like, nigga, it was like making a bottle for a baby, dog. When that nigga was sending you to go get that, because you knew you had to warm it up and all that shit. That bitch set that shit up like a baby bottle.
Like, shit.
Oh, man. I am traumatized. My life is crazy. My family not normal, man. Family not normal. I don't think nobody family normal, nigga. Galaxy Avengers. They're from somewhere else. Oh, man.
I like that the weird part is, too, you can kind of wrap your head around him drinking gravy, but the fact that his favorite is chicken gravy, that's like the really disturbing part. It's like, really? Why?
bro. But it's the fact that he would down a meatloaf gravy. Oof. Because this particular meatloaf gravy had stripes of red in it.
Oh.
So I guess that's because meatloaf is supposed to have some sort of red stuff on it. I don't know, but... Nah, that shit was like that peanut butter and that jelly of Jubers or something.
Oh, Goobers, yeah.
Yeah, I love that. But it makes my burp smell like a fart. I'd be gambling with Cuzzo and them, and I'd be burping farts, and I'd be blowing it over to them. And so, let me tell you something. They'd be like, yo, who the fuck farted? And I'd be like, something over here. Niggas over here be like, nah, we don't smell nothing over here. And then niggas like, nah. And then once it finally come over on outside, niggas be like, yo, what the fuck? Yo, yeah, that's Bonnie, yo. Bonnie farting. I swear to God.
Oh my God.
My digestive system was going through some shit. It does something weird to me, man. I love Gooblers, though. That's a great snack to have when you're fucking stoned and just vegged out on your fucking couch,
stop
bro.
Stop the jar?
Yeah. Watching the Pinky Blinders. Yo, dude, I've got... Let me tell you something, man. I was out and about last week, and I found my fucking Pinky Blinder watches. I was so... Dude, I called you and told you. I was so excited about that. I found it in K Jewelers.
Oh, okay.
Every kiss begins with K. K. Yeah. Yeah, man. Oh, man. Let me tell you, I had an awesome 4th of July weekend, man. You know, got to get out of the city. Got to experience some culture, and let me tell you something, man. It's so ironic that you said that you had a good old American 4th of July. You know, because it's something about white people that will let you know that we all should feel American. And when they blast this song out, I don't give a fuck how many niggers is in the mix, bro. Yo, bro, you can pump that African American, you can pump that African shit all you want, but when Bruce Springsteen hits you with that Born in the USA, nigga, from the first drum thump, you are American, nigga. Let me tell you something, man. Let me know if I'm bugging or not, man. To all my homies, all my niggas and my bitches out there right now, bro. When you hear this, tell me you don't feel American, bro. G-Money, hit me with that shit, man. Yeah. Yeah. Come on. Yeah. Come on. American, baby. This shit make you want to go mining. Okay? Yeah. All right? Born down in a dead man's town. Come on. Fucking A, man. Can't help yourself. The whiteness come out. It comes out without your permission, nigga. Yeah, you're patriotic. Yeah. Yeah, man. Man, listen. Man, you, bro, you feel patriotic like a motherfucker. I was American this weekend, man. I mean, I'm American every week. I don't give a fuck what nobody's talking about. I'm American every week. Thank God for freedom. Shout out to all the soldiers that's on the front line protecting our freedom. But let me tell you some crazy shit. Let me tell you some crazy shit, though, right? The crazy shit is this. They got into a conversation about Bruce Springsteen because, you know, when white people play music, they like play all the hits. You know what I mean? They don't stop. You know, it's one thing after another, man. One thing after another. And let me tell you something. Those hits, they were coming. They were coming. But this song came on that got a conversation going. And I never looked at this song like this before until it was pointed out. Dancing in the Dark. Dancing in the Dark by Bruce Springsteen. People, I need y'all to follow me. I am not here to taint the legend of the motherfucking boss in no way, form, or fashion. All right? Listen to me. Hey, little girl, is your daddy home? Did he go and leave you all alone? No, no. I got a bad desire. Ooh, I'm on fire. Tell me now, baby, is it good to you? Can't do to you the things I don't do? Oh, no. I could take you higher. Ooh, I'm on fire. I love that fucking song. I don't know why. I just really love that song, though. But listen to me. Listen to me. Here we go. They got to talking about this one particular song, Dancing in the Dark. And they pointed out that this song was about the solicitation. I think I said that word right. Solicitation. I feel like Will Ferrell in Old School when he was on the debate team and he blacked out for people. Okay, the solicitation of a prostitute. And people, we might have a settled delay in G-Money talk, but we're going to get this shit out. Because let me tell you something, it made a lot of sense to me. We're going to break this down, people. And y'all tell me, man, It's nothing wrong with the boss. Hey, man, this was my mistake. I should have paid. I should have paid. Instead of fucking not, I wouldn't be in this jail. Hey, yo! The solicitation. Okay? Here we go. Here we go. People, tell me if this is making any sense. No disrespect to the boss. You're a fucking icon. You're one of my heroes, and that will never change. Come on, let's go. Turn it up. The solicitation of a prostitute. We gotta focus in on the words.
I get up in the evening, and I ain't got nothing to say. I come home in the morning, I go to bed feeling the
stop. Okay. He done expressed to us he's waking up in the evening, there's no activities. He comes home in the morning, and he go into bed the same fucking way. So he ain't got shit to do but work and sleep. Let's get a little deeper.
I ain't nothing but tired.
Why?
Man, I'm just tired and bored with myself.
Stop! He ain't nothing but tired, I guess from jerking off, because he just said it. He just said it. He's just tired and bored with himself. That's a state of masturbation. So he's looking for something more. What is he looking for? Tell us, boss.
Hey there, baby. I could use just a little.
Stop! What is he looking for?
I kicked up a notch.
Hey there, baby. He could use just a little bit of help. What kind of help can she offer you, boss? Tell us, Bruce.
Can't start a fire. You can't start a fire without a spark.
That's a fact. You cannot start a fire without a spark. And let me tell you something about that friction, man. When those things get to going, man, it's the 4th of July every time, baby. That's what I know. Come on, Bruce, tell us what's going on.
This gun's for hire.
This gun's for hire.
Even if we're just dancing in the dark.
Stop! This gun's for hire, even if we're just dancing in the dark. Who gets hired to do things in the dark? Prostitutes! Prostitutes! Yeah! Dark alleyways, dark parking lots, dark alleys. Come on, man. We can keep going on with the darkness. Dark balloon knots. Come on, man. Come on, Bruce. Tell talk to us. Talk to us, Bruce. Come on. Press play. Yeah.
Messages keep getting clearer.
It's getting clearer.
Radio's on.
Get motivation. Yep.
Wanna change my clothes, my hair, my
stop! Why would he want to change his nose, his hair, his face? He needs a disguise. He cannot just go out there and get prostitutes. Bitches know he's the Bruce, the boss. No! He wants to be disguised. A lot of niggas out here that don't want to be out there. Listen. Listen. I mean, Eddie and these niggas called with those niggas. Niggas wish they had a disguise. Bruce is on to something. Come on, press play.
Nowhere. I'm just living in a dump like this. There's something happening somewhere.
Yeah, it is.
Baby, I just know you can't.
Stop. There's something happening somewhere. Baby, I just want to get in. What do you want to get in, boss? Come on, Bruce. Gennaro, are you listening to this?
I'm hearing it.
Thus far, we're going to hit you with the thus far. What are your thoughts?
Well, it sounds like that Bruce comes home at night with nothing to do, and he's looking for an activity.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Outside of his normal activity.
Outside of his normal activity.
That makes him drowsy
yeah.
and bored with himself. because he's tired and bored with himself.
So he needs some company. Mm-hmm. So he's out looking for company.
Mm-hmm. That's you're getting this.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah,
all right. Yeah. Let's come on. Come on. Press play. We've been here before. We know. Why in the dark, dude? I mean, I love the dark. My body's horrible. I don't want to be alfing out nowhere. Okay? My body looks like Alf, nigga. Look. Nowhere. There's a joke, it's wild, and it's on me. I shake this world off my shoulders. Come on, baby, the laugh's on me. Stop. The laughs on him, there was some activities that went on. I guess that nigga nutted quick or whatever. But, man, listen, he's telling on himself. This isn't me. I think this is genius. I didn't even know he was, I didn't even know that Bruce was out here street walking. Street hawking. Yeah, street. You're a hawk of the streets. Press play.
On the streets of this town. And they'll be carving you up all right. You say you gotta stay hungry. Hungry for what? Hey, baby, I'm
just a bastard. Stop! They say you gotta stay hungry. And he lets her know, hey, baby, I'm just about starving tonight. Well, it's a good thing we know that the boss eats pussy. Okay? At least we all know out here, Bruce is letting niggas know, eat that pussy! Yeah, the boss! How the fuck you think Jersey girls were invented? Fuck out of here. I feel you, boss. I feel you, Bruce. Let's go. Eat pussy, Gennaro. Go ahead. You heard what the boss said. He's dying for some action. Stop. That nigga don't want to write no more. He done. Nigga want to go out there and fornicate. Nigga want to go out there and street hawk. This nigga is fed up being in the house alone. He ain't got no friends. Nigga started a book club by himself. Good. I need a love reaction. Come on, baby, give me just one look. Yo, fam. He's looking for a little bit of action. Baby, come on, just give him one look. When he's riding by, scouting out the prostitute, he's just looking for one to lock in. Hey. Hello. Hey, he's letting us know. He's letting us know how to pick up prostitutes. There's a lot going on here. This song is so educational now. And this is all because of a great fucking 4th of July weekend. I was educated. Like, I'm not mad at the boss. No. The boss, hey, man. We can just listen to a little bit and before we get into G Money talk because he's just an innovator, man.
I've never heard of it. I listened to a lot of Bruce Springsteen in my days of living in New Jersey, and I feel like that part's probably blocked out from the New Jersey history of it. You heard it out of state, you know, you did not hear it in New Jersey.
Mm-hmm,
so
mm-hmm.
That's
I was in a whole nother state, man, when I heard it, but the person was from New Jersey that said it.
Really?
Yeah.
Fucking rap.
Oh, man. But it's all right. Nah. It was good information because I look at the boss in a whole nother light now. He's more of an iconic hero.
Yeah.
He's not just a mortal god. You know what I mean? He's godly.
And he could have done that. Like, he could have still made that song, made it sound that way, and then done the music video with, like, showing that part of the song. But he just chose to make him fucking dancing up there, having a good fucking time.
With the Marlboro Red t-shirt joint. That's all you need is some Marlboro Reds up there, dog. You know what I mean? Yo, let me tell you something about Bruce Springsteen. That nigga made steel workers feel sexy. Niggas with the bare bellies. The bare bellies. I'm talking about the shit that hung over and part belly exposed. Yeah, the niggas that was welders in the welding fires would hit their belly, but they would be unfazed. He had these niggas feeling like they were sexy, bro. Yeah, duh. Him and Bon Jovi, bro. Him and Bon Jovi. That fucking Living on a Prayer. That Living on a Prayer gives niggas and a fucking anthem to being unemployed. and motivate bitches to stay with them at the same time. That's a song that says to a bitch, listen, I'm fucked up right now, but go to the diner and bring home that pay. You know what I mean? Like, hold us down because I'm going to make it happen later. You know what I mean? And if you don't believe me, if you don't want to hear it from me, listen to the Bond, okay? And say, nigga, it's just something about when Bond says it, it just sounds a lot better. Can you pull it up for me, please? Okay. Can you pull that shit up for me? Like, yo, bro, it's one thing when you broke and you trying to explain to your bitch you broke, okay? But she not hearing you. I'm telling you, man, y'all better start getting into soundtracks to your motherfucking situation. And you got to ease them into it, man. Like, you got to play this song when she coming home from work. Okay? You know she just buzzed the door for you to buzz her into the building. You got to press play when she's making her way upstairs. And you got to start utilizing the meat that you took out of the freezer to defrost so she could start making the hamburger helper for y'all. You know what I mean? But you got to also make sure that that bath is ran, that she feels like, wow, this nigga's out here. He ain't got no job. He fucked up, and he got a soundtrack to his fuck up, and this still motivates me to go and get that money and come home. This song gives niggas permission to be fucked up. Listen to the lyrics of this shit, man. And tell me if a bitch don't want to stay with a nigga. That thing, because you know niggas is using that potential motherfucking wave with hoes, man. They, I got potential. Because bitches be with niggas for potential purposes. Fuck that. Potential, nah, nigga, you got to graduate, bro. Fuck that. I need, go out in the world and get experience. Come back. But tell me that this song is the most inspirational song to the soundtrack of a broke nigga trying to keep his bitch with him. Press play. Turn me up, man. We need all the broke niggas to feel this song. There is a broke nigga listening to this shit like, oh my God, why didn't I think of this? You gotta be playing this shit when she's walking into the motherfucking house, dog. The pan, the fryers, the shit is on. You're throwing the meat in there, sizzling. The onions is all chopped up, the peppers. You know what I mean? You're looking at her, helping her. Motherfucking put stuff on the motherfucking coat rack and shit. You know, I don't know, you good. But he's unemployed now.
So tough.
You gotta kind of start singing this to your bitch, bro. You know what I mean? While you cooking?
Working for a man, she brings home a pay for love.
Let me tell you something. That's when you know you got a rider.
Hold on to what we got. Doesn't make a difference if we make it or not. We got each other, and that's a lot for love.
If she jumps in, you got a rider. Oh,
halfway there. Living on the prayer.
Yeah. Living. Yo, turn that shit off, son. I swear to God, if she joins in on the chorus, my nigga, you got at least another 3 years of unemployment that you can rock out with it at the house.
Whoa, we're halfway there.
This bitch don't even know. You're the whole way there. You're everything. There's no half, nothing. This nigga's not going to have the half. He's not trying to bring half. You know, there's niggas that was with bitches during the pandemic that was claiming that they were broke and had mad money. And bitches was backed up and rent and all kind of shit. And niggas out here spending money on other bitches and shit like that while his main bitch is in the crib struggling. Niggas is wild.
They're out there doing that? That's crazy.
I'm niggas. Niggas, bro. I know I wasn't the only one. Watch these niggas, ladies. Watch these niggas. And with that being said, well, I'm sorry for the delay, y'all, but guess what? It's G-Money Talk!
I'm spitting 16 mini lines from a 603. G-Money, what you got for me? Come on, come on. G-Money, what you got for me? We got Jimmy over there in the Buffalo plaid. And in the Buffalo stance. Come on, G-Money, what you got for me? It's the 30-minute mark. Come on,
hey,
come on,
yeah. Hey, hey. All right. All right, now. I'm a DJ.
Yes, you are. Oh, shit. Shout out to Josh, as always, for that. Mm-hmm. And fucking shout out to our new patron, who
what?
I'm going to shout out right now. That's
niggas is coming
super
back.
Super dope. They're coming back, bro. They're fucking.
Niggas is coming back.
They
shout
are
out
coming
to
back.
That,
I'm
going to
pull that name up right now because I don't have it in front of me. But you can go to patreon.com/fireinthehole where you get the video version of the show. And all sorts of bonus content. We got
that's
the
Dino. That's that Dino right there. Niggas is coming
that,
back.
That Dino came back?
That Dino.
Where's he at? Where's he at? Where's he at? Where's he at?
Dre Aaron? Did I say that right?
Dre Aaron?
Iron? Some Iron? Shit like that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. 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 Dre yeah. Aaron. Yes.
Yes.
Shout out to Dre Aaron. Welcome.
Yo,
welcome
why does
to the
he sound like a sniper?
Oh,
he's on the firing squad.
Why does he? He got like a fucking sniper. We're gonna need Dre Aaron on this one. One shot, one kill. Yeah, Dre Aaron's the guy for this job. Oh man, welcome to the family, Dre.
Shit. Welcome to the family, Dre. All
right. Niggas is here.
First thing we got to talk about this week is, Jimmy, your name was brought up on a podcast here with Sal Vulcano and Joe Derosa.
I remember. I love Joe. He plays drums.
Does he?
He plays drums and I always wanted to be get in a band with him, man. I always wanted. Always wanted. He is always pretty mesmerized that I was into like this rock music and shit.
Yes,
like
yeah,
that.
He actually does bring that up like that towards the end of this book about your music taste and everything. Yeah, this is about where it starts. It might take a couple seconds to jump in here. This is actually Joe DeRosa, Sal Vulcano, and Nate Borghese.
Nate, fucking Nate.
We were at the Boston Comedy Club. It was when PJ Landers was running the Boston Comedy Club. Remember that? And Keith's holding this fucking Tupperware.
PJ.
Dude, filled with homemade gravy and meatballs and everything. And Bobby goes, "Where'd you get that from?" And Keith goes, "Lynn Coppola's made it for me." And Bobby goes,
"Why?"
"Why
does he sound just like Keith?" "Why does he sound just like fucking Keith?" Hilarious.
"Because she likes me, stupid." And Bobby goes, "Oh, yeah?" Boom. Just hits it. The thing just hits the ground. It goes fucking everywhere. Keith starts laughing, like hyperventilating laughing at how mean it is. Goes and sits on the side. Bobby's laughing. I'm laughing. We sat there and just watched PJ sweep it all up. Yeah. And PJ was like,
PJ can murder.
He
used
to terrorize
PJ. Yeah, and he didn't
want to
PJ. Yell at Keith. Or
that's crazy. He's terror. PJ, when he first got, was running the Boston Comedy Club. I used to tease him and bother him down there because he wouldn't put me on and shit like that. But that was my nigga, though. We got into a fight and all that shit, man.
Bobby, yeah, like because they were like so established, like yeah. So he just mopped it all up.
PJ fought Jimmy Martinez. Did
yes.
They fight it? Yeah.
PJ earned his stripes more than one that day.
Yeah,
that's a fact.
We were all scared of Jimmy. I love Jimmy, but we were scared to death
like
of Jimmy.
Fist fought?
Oh yeah. And they were, and they're just so both big dudes. Like it's and PJ
you
was
just watched it?
I don't remember. I just remember hearing about it, but it was like such a it was such a, like a seemed a fair fight. Like it was like if those two dudes were fighting, it's two big dudes. Jimmy Martinez used to every time he would do a show, he wouldn't need the microphone. So we'd go to the improv, and I was, like, running it with Dustin.
Yeah.
Or the Broadway Comedy Club. It was the improv at the time. And so that upstairs
he remembers that.
So Jimmy would...
He remembers that. All right, Nate. That... Yeah, let me tell you something, man. I did not like him. I was always... How do I say this? I always thought that Nate was a real smart comic. A sarcastically smart comic. And it was authentic because that's who he was as an individual. Mm. You know, I didn't think he was trying to be something on stage. Like a lot of people didn't understand why I love Dustin Chafin, because Dustin is really who he is on stage, off stage. You know, you have to admire motherfuckers like that. But I always felt like I was too much for Nate, and he didn't understand me, and he was always on alert. Like, and I'm not saying that that incident at the Boston Comedy Club when I fucking mashed up like 8 comics and with like I had like 8, 9, maybe 10, 11, 12 shots of Grand Marnier. It was a bad night. I got banned from the Boston by Barry Katz, all that. But I always just thought that Nate didn't get me, and it bothered me because I liked him, you know what I'm saying? But I just knew, you ever know like a big dog, like a Saint Bernard with too much energy, and you're just like, oh, you're shedding on, oh. Yeah, I felt like that for Nate, you know? But when I saw him start getting some light and shit like that, I was happy for him, you know? Like, and it was his lane. Mm. He didn't switch up, and I was like, mm-hmm. You know, these are moments of individuals finding their iconicness within, you know what I mean? So, yeah, I just never thought that Nate really got me, you know what I mean?
That's a great way to describe your vibe to people who don't like you or don't like get you at first, is you being a Saint Bernard who is like, what are we doing, guys? We're going to play? We're going to play? They're just like, oh, my God. They're not...
I feel sorry for people that get cheated from to get to know the real me. I feel sorry for people that get caught up in this fucking image. Oh, no, this nigga's a gangster. Oh, these stupid fucking idiots. Like, these are legends that are made from other people. I mean, I'm just a guy that don't do dumb shit to me, man. I'm like every fucking human being on earth. You know, don't do dumb shit to me. But I would prefer to play over everything. I want to play. I want to throw frisbees. I want to make strawberry quick and stuff. I want to have fun. I want to do fun shit. I want to listen to fucking Bruce Springsteen dancing in the dark. You know what I mean? Like,
that's a great frisbee song. That's
my God. All right, let's listen. Joe's such an awesome guy too, man. He's never been scared of me either.
No, yeah, he's just saying, but he just means it's like,
To hear him say that, if he was scared of me, he hid that shit well, because he was always so open. Jimmy, hey, come here, man, come here. Like, he used to seek me out. He wouldn't even be on my radar, or maybe he was just so scared. He's like, hey, let me head him off. Hey, Jim, hey, I'm, why would you call danger over to you? Let's go over here. What's going on? Hey, what's up, man? He will always disarm me. I never knew. I never knew he was scared of me. I just thought that he liked me a lot. Oh, my God. Oh, why do people do this? Stop villainizing me. I'm a good guy. my God. I'm sorry.
We go on stage and like get the microphone and just walk it all the way off to the side of the stage and then just do his act with no microphone because he talked loud. And then he'd say goodnight and I was hosting and I always had to go get the microphone. I'd be so mad because I was like, I got to walk over there like an idiot and just like, got to gather all your things because you won't.
Dude, I saw Jimmy once. He was on stage at Stamp New York. No mic. Mike Britt walked in. And Mike Britt was standing. So Stand Up New York, you know how it's set up. There's like the bar. And then there was, I don't think the window's there anymore.
I love Mike Britt. You got to understand. He's like one of my comedic heroes from like the Uptown Comedy Club days. Like, he is a fucking comedic genius. And Mike Britt is a fucking hell of an actor. Hell of an actor. I loved him on Boardwalk Empire. He needs to pursue more acting because his serious acting skills are fucking phenomenal. Mm. Yeah, Mike Britt. I get crazy. Whenever I see him in Mike Yard,
yeah,
I get nuts. It's like running in to Patrice or Corey or something like that, you know?
Opening at the end of the bar was a service window. So if you were on stage, you could see clear into the bar, but it was still a separate room. Jimmy was on stage, saw Mike Britt walk into the bar, and he goes, oh, shit, my man, left the stage, went over and had a four-minute conversation with Mike Britt at the bar, and then walked back like nothing happened. Nothing. It was literally just his impulse that came over him, and he just went and did it.
Yeah.
The crowd was in the middle of water.
Crowd was like, what the fuck is going on?
Dude.
Yo, I remember that stupid shit. I remember that. I don't know what happened. It wasn't for 4 minutes. He's fucking exaggerated. But it was a little bit. And I remember the crowd mumbling amongst themselves. You know, like we were in Rome and they were the Republic. Oh, what was this happening? Have that piece mic out. Mike was like, yo, you on stage? I was like, oh, yeah, I'm about to get back up. He's like, they get back on stage. I was like, all right, yo, stay right here. I want to talk to you. And I went back on stage. And, yo, I can't believe Joe remembered that shit. He ain't lying. He ain't lying. At least he's got some at least these niggas is telling accurate stories.
Yeah, I cracked up when I watched this for the first time when Nate said that you gather your things. Because when you're done with your act, that's like when you're ending, doing your last joke, you're starting to pick your things up and like your glasses, your blunt, like everything. And that part, I just pictured you picking everything up and leaving the microphone. And I fucking had a good laugh at that.
Yo, Nate used to dead panel exit. All right, everyone, give it up for Jimmy. I think he's... I was like, dude, come on, man. It's right there, bro. Stop.
It's right there.
Stop, bro. Stop. You're a winner, man. Oh, it's not making you look what is it's making the show look dope. This fucking rock star just fucking exit the stage and you're looking like an angry promoter. That didn't really want him on a bill. You know what I mean? Like, oh, my fucking God. I used to love those days with Nate. Oh my goodness. It's Dustin Chafin, man. Fucking another funny-ass guy.
Dustin Chafin. I don't know if I've met Dustin Chafin. The name sounds familiar, but I don't know if I've
just another funny motherfucker, bro. Just really another. Oh, my goodness. I remember one time I hung out with Dustin, Shane, and Ronan. With the bartenders from the Bag It In. Niggas was walking up the block, kissing random women. Shane looked like Noel Gallagher from fucking Oasis. Sound just like him and all that. And they would walk up, and these white bitches would be tonguing them down. Yo, I'd be like, I can't do that. Not me. What's happening here? Battery. I'm sorry for interrupting you, G-Money.
No, that's okay. I'm fucking perfect.
What else we got going?
This is like they got a little bit of this clip left. They do mention you a little bit more.
Dude, Jimmy's the best, dude. Like he's
yeah, Jimmy's awesome, man.
Awesome. Like it was that dude was yeah. It was just another. Didn't he like some what band? He like loved. He was friends with some.
He loved like the widest bands.
Yeah.
He loved like Offspring.
Yeah.
And stuff like that. Like he loved like the widest like California poppy punk bands.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. He's awesome. I still
see. Hey, yo, is that the guy from Practical Jokers?
Yes, it is. Yeah.
Oh my God, dude! You know what's crazy? He's sitting there like, "Who is this guy?" I want to join in, but I don't. I don't want to say something that maybe I don't.
He's intrigued. But
yeah, yeah, he is intrigued. I'm sorry. I was like, this guy looks familiar. I thought I went to school with him. Like, we were in special ed together or something. Like, in the blue section of the school. But nah, I don't know him from school. Go ahead. Go ahead.
I think that's about it. That's about it with that.
Just go ahead. But press play. I want to see what they're talking about. What band?
Good guy, man. I miss him. I miss him.
I miss Jimmy, too.
We could do this. We could do this all damn day.
I miss you guys, too, man. I miss you guys. I miss the old days, guys. I'm really proud of you, Nate. I'm really proud of you, bro. I'm glad you got your just in the game. You deserve it. Joe, you stay working, bro. You know what I'm saying? I'm really happy with my nigga Dustin Schaefer because this was a whole nother click. Like, I had the poster doll click. I had the Dustin Schaefer click. And then I had the black comedy scene and shit like that. But, you know, Luis Gomez with the poster dog niggas, Martin and all those wild niggas. Oh, my God. The poster dog days. Oh, my God. It was like we were like the kids from Where the Day Takes You. It's like this movie of Runaways or some shit like that. Like, we were outside for real, bro. Like, yeah, and Dustin's crew. Yeah, man. Comedy's been interesting. It's always been a dope scene. It's always been a really dope scene. What else we got? I'm sorry.
This should take us out, this video, but this is a fucking crazy video. I'm not sure where this takes place, but this is a... Well, the first time I've seen this method to get away from the cops.
State troopers in Vermont say when they tried to arrest a man, his dad tried to attack them with an excavator machine. The state police say two troopers went to arrest 24-year-old Brandon Tallman after he allegedly had an altercation with his neighbor. But as they attempted to handcuff Tallman, the troopers say his mother tried to stop them. And then his father maneuvered his excavator's bucket near the troopers and their vehicles, causing them to retreat.
All available units, I've got 343 and 254 in a 1010.
Now the whole family faces charges in connection with the incident. Brandon Tallman has pleaded not guilty to aggravated assault, burglary, unlawful mischief, and resisting arrest. His father, Wayne, is charged with aggravated assault on protected officials, resisting arrest, impeding, and reckless endangerment. The mother, Amy, was given a citation for impeding and is ordered to appear in court in August. State troop.
Yo, my nigga, when the wife was like, honey, they got our son. The nigga was in the midst of watching Avatar. And the nigga said, okay, I got their asses. And he went Avatar machine transformer on these niggas. Yo, fam, come on, man. Yo, white people are, yo, don't ever say that you are not necessary on earth, man. No one else thinking like y'all do. This niggas. Those niggas lucky he didn't have a RoboCop suit. That nigga would have jumped into his RoboCops. I'm coming, honey. Drop it.
It's probably half built. It probably was like, he tried it on like, fuck, it's not ready yet. And then went to plan B.
Oh, man, this nigga had an Iron Man suit that he's been working on. Oh, it's fucking idiots, man. Well, I hope you guys had a safe 4th of July weekend, man, and all your limbs are intact and your lovers are still in place and everyone's just, you know, glad to be fucking American, man. If you're having the problem, the question in that, get some Bruce Springsteen in your life. Some Born in the USA. If you ever want to question your patriotism, that's listen to that. And if you don't get the rocking, yeah, you need to pack your things and go. That's a fact. You don't belong here in America, Jack. All right. With that being said, G-Money, if they wanted to get in touch with us and interact with us and figure out, you know, how to get down, because they know how to get in touch with me. I still got the same number, 917-792-1593. If they wanted to get at us, how could they do that?
Well, they could send us an email, fireintheholeny@gmail.com. They could follow the show on Twitter and Instagram, @fireintheholeny. They could subscribe to our YouTube channel where they get clips of the show and the audio version of the show, but you can only get the full video version of the show along with other bonus content at patreon.com/fireinthehole. And if you want to send us some artwork or send us a letter, P.O. Box 3553, New York, New York, 10027. P.O. Box 3553, New York, New York, 10027.
Hey, remember, man, they said fuck you first. They thought they fuck you was going to break you. But that fuck you motivated you to get you to the next level. Stay on your grind. Stay focused. And keep those fuck yous in their proper perspectives. Until next week, niggas. Holla!